डिस्टिंग्विश गेस्ट, स्टूडेंट्स, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, बिफोर स्टार्टिंग वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग लेक्चर ऑफ प्रोक्लेमेशन ऑफ इमरजेंसी इन डेमोक्रेटिक इंडिया, आई वुड लाइक टू से दैट फॉर्चुनेटली वी आर लिविंग इन द इंडिपेंडेंट एंड डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री विच इज गवर्न बाय रूल ऑफ लॉ, हैविंग फंडामेंटल राइट्स विच इज इंस्क्राइब्ड इन पार्ट थर्ड ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया, बट द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया इज एम्पावर्ड टू इम्पोज एक्सटर्नल एंड इंटरनल इमरजेंसी अंडर आर्टिकल 352, 356 एंड 360 प्रोवाइडेड इन पार्ट 18 ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया on the aid and advice of the council of ministers including the prime minister. If the president is satisfied that a grave emergency exists whereby the security of India or a part of the territory is threatened, whether by war or external aggression or armed revolution, he may by proclamation make a declaration to hold of India or of such part the territory as may be prescribed in the proclamation. On June 25th, 1975, the President of India, Fakhruddin Ali Ahmed, declared an internal emergency on the advice of Prime Minister Indira Gandhi just a few minutes before the midnight. Invoking Article 352 of the Constitution of India, Gandhi granted herself extraordinary power and launched a massive crackdown on civil rights and political opponents. The government used police force across the country to place thousands of protesters and strike leaders under preventive detention, like Jayaprakash Narayan, राज नारायण, मुरारजी देसाई, अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी, विजय राजे सिंधिया, लाल कृष्ण आडवाणी, अरुण जेटली, सत्येंद्र नाथ सिन्हा, जीवतराम कृपलानी, गायत्री देवी, द क्वीन ऑफ जयपुर वेयर इमीडिएटली अरेस्टेड. ऑर्गेनाइजेशन लाइक आरएसएस एंड जमात ए इस्लाम अलोंग विद सम पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज वेयर बैंड. Arun Jaitley, head of the ABBP in Delhi, was also arrested and he spent the entire period of emergency in jail. Arrest warrant were issued against large number of people including senior advocate Ram Jethmalani, who was the chairman of the Bar Council of India. Fortunately, the Bombay High Court has granted the stay of arrest. He appeared before the Honorable Supreme Court certainly to oppose the emergency and to expose that she has done with the Indian Constitution and democracy. Despite emergency, the court fully empowered to protect human liberty and they done a wonderful job. But against the judgment of 9 High Court in India, the said dictator took an appeal to the Supreme Court. Famous advocate Sri Ram Jethmalani appeared in the Supreme Court as an advocate for the several detainees and vehemently argued before the Honorable Supreme Court. The opposition movement against the emergency has also seen rise of several top leaders like Jayaprakash Narayan, Morarji Desai, Subramaniam Swami, Atal Bihari Vajpayee, Lal Krishna Advani, H.D. Devegowda, Jyoti Basu, Lalu Prasad Yadav, Mulayam Singh Yadav, Sarad Yadav, and many others. The opposition was brutally oppressed and put behind the bar. Indira Gandhi ruled for another 2 years in such condition, and The media institutions were also instructed to report as per government feasibility. Media had no power at all, but only Ramnath Goenka, a newspaper owner who stood up to the Indira Gandhi, he was arrested. All India Radio was asked to stop play. Indira Gandhi devised 20 points economic program to increase agriculture and industrial production, impose public service to fight poverty and illiteracy through the discipline of graveyard. In addition to the official 20 points, her son Sanjay Gandhi also declared his 5 points program to promote the family planning, literacy, tree plantation, eradication of casteism, abolition of dowry. Friends, this was the impact of the emergency in India. Now, what was the reason to impose the emergency is that due to her last prime ministership, Indira Gandhi has a strong support in the disadvantaged sections like poor, Dalit, women and minorities, and secularism as being pro-poor and for the development of nation as a whole. In March 1971, general election, people repose confidence upon Indira Gandhi's slogan, Garibi Hatao, that awarded her a huge majority of 352 seats out of 518. As in last government, Prime Minister Indira Gandhi could not take a strong decision to develop India due to internal disputes in her party. However, this elections gave her full majority in the Lok Sabha, therefore she started working to make India a developed and powerful country. On the other hand, her son Sanjay Gandhi had a dream to make people cars in India. Therefore, in 1971, Prime Minister Indira Gandhi cabinet proposed the production of people car for middle class. In June 1971, a company known as Maruti Motors Limited was incorporated under the Companies Act and Sanjay Gandhi became its managing director. The criticism that flowed this decision was mostly directed at Indira Gandhi. Public prescriptions turned against Sanjay and many began to speculate growing corruption and nepotism. On December 16, 1971, under her proactive bar leadership, Indira routed arch enemy Pakistan in a bar that led to the independence of Bangladesh. White 24th amendment, she amended Article 13 and 368 by adding Clause 4 in Article 13 and Clause 3 in Article 368, and mentioned in both clause that there is no connection with each other, and enable the parliament to dilute fundamental rights through amendment. The amendment further made it obligatory for the president to give his assents when a constitution amendment bill was presented to him. In 1970, the Supreme Court in R.C. Cooper versus Union of India, popularly known as the bank nationalization case, held that the constitution guarantees the right to compensation, that is equivalent money of acquiring property, compulsory. The court also held that seeks to acquire any property for public purpose must satisfy the requirement of Article 19(1)(f). Therefore, in 1971, while the 25th Constitution Amendment curtailed the right to property and permitted the acquisition of private property by the government for public use on the payment of compensation, which would be determined by the parliament and not by the court, and added clause C in Article 31, which says if any law declared by the parliament under Article 39B and 39C, then the Article 14, 19 and 31 shall not apply. The amendment upheld by the Supreme Court in a famous case, Keshavananda Bharati versus State of Kerala in 1973, and why 26th Constitution Amendment abolished of privy purse and finally ended all the entitlement and special status of former ruler, thus turning them into ordinary citizen equal to others. Many of the former ruler protested against the privy purse. They contested Lok Sabha election, but except Vijayaraja Sindhya and her son Madhavrao Sindhya, all were defeated. Why 29 Constitution Amendment, she amended the Land Reform Act and inserted in 9th Schedule. The amendment was challenged in the Supreme Court, but 13 judges of the Constitution Bench of Supreme Court overruled the earlier 11 judges Constitution Bench judgment passed in IC Golaknath case and given the doctrine of basic structure in Keshavananda Bharati case. White 30 Constitution Amendment, she amended Article 133 of the Constitution of India and changed the rule of civil appellate jurisdiction of Supreme Court and made it clear that only involving substantial question of law, such case can move directly to the Supreme Court. December 1971, the Gujarat government enhanced 20% of hostel fee. Therefore, the student of LD Engineering College called for a strike, and Morarji Desai also joined the strike, and they started demanding resignation of Gujarat CM Chimanbhai Patel, who was the CM of Congress Party. The protest turned violent. They get written the resignation forcefully from the several MLAs and handed over to the House of Speaker. Finally, Indira Gandhi was in pressure, had to dissolve the Congress ruling Gujarat government. Why? 33rd Constitution Amendment prescribes procedure for resignation by members of Parliament and State Legislature and procedure for verification and acceptance of the resignation by House of Speaker. On February 18, 1974, Bihar Chhatra Sangh Samiti President Sri Lalu Prasad Yadav, along with Sushil Modi, Ramvilas Paswan and other leader of his Samiti, has given ultimatum to the Bihar government that all the students will surround it at Vidhan Sabha, and on the basis of corruption, they demanding resignation of Bihar CM Abdul Ghafoor of Congress Party. But Indira Gandhi rejected the demand of students. In that protest, 3 students were killed. Thereafter, JB joined the strike and he has given new name of the movement as Sampurna Kranti. He promised to the activists and public, please give me 1 year, I will give you a good governance. Not only this, in 1974, George Fernandez called a railway strike for locomotives, which continued till 20 days. 70% employee taken part in the strike, but इंदिरा गांधी हैज टेकन स्ट्रॉन्ग एक्शन अगेंस्ट द एम्प्लॉय देयरफॉर द रेलवे स्ट्राइक एंडेड विदाउट एनी रिजल्ट डिस्पाइट इंटरनल डिस्टर्बेंस इंदिरा गांधी डेड इंडियाज फर्स्ट सक्सेसफुल न्यूक्लियर टेस्ट ऑन May 18, 1974 पॉपुलरली नोन पोखरण परमाणु परीक्षण नेम स्माइलिंग बुद्धा ऑन दैट डे इंडिया बिकम द न्यूक्लियर सुपर पावर बाय दैट सैड न्यूक्लियर बॉम्ब टेस्ट इंदिरा गांधी चेंज द इमेज ऑफ इंडिया इन द वर्ल्ड इन बिटवीन द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया इलेक्शन वॉज ड्यू इंदिरा गांधी मेड कैंडिडेट ऑफ कांग्रेस पार्टी टू एडवोकेट फखरुद्दीन अली अहमद ही वॉज फ्रॉम आसाम ही बिकम द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया वाइट 36 कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन अमेंडमेंट इंदिरा गांधी मेड प्रोविजन फॉर मर्जिंग द सिक्किम इन इंडिया इंदिरा गांधी प्रिपेयर्ड अ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन फॉर सिक्किम दैट वॉज approved by its National Assembly in 1974 in a special reference held in 1975. More than 97% of the electors voted for the merger of Sikkim with India and the Sikkim became the 22nd state of India on May 16, 1975. But on June 12, 1975, Justice Jagmohan Lal Sinha, Judge Allahabad High Court pronounced judgment in Indira Gandhi election case filed by her opponent Raj Narayan, by which the court rejected 12 charges against her but found guilty under Section 123(7) of the Representation of People Act in other two charges and declare her election null and void and debar her to contest any election in future for 6 years and granted 20 days time to make alternative arrangement or file a case against this judgment before the Honorable Supreme Court. The opposition called a meeting on 22nd June in Delhi which was to be addressed by JP but due to rain, his plane was not fly to Delhi to join the meeting and finally Morarji Desai addressed the successful meeting. Indira Gandhi filed appeal in the Supreme Court which was listed on 24th June 1975. Senior advocate Nani Palkiwala appeared for her and senior advocate Shanti Bhushan appeared for Raj Narayan. The vacation judge B.R. Krishna Iyer granted interim stay and allowed Indira Gandhi to work as Prime Minister of India but restricted her not to join parliamentary proceeding till the final judgment. On 25th June, opposite party called a successful march in Delhi. In that protest, JP made an appeal to the government officers and employee that not to obey the Prime Minister of India, Indira Gandhi, because she has no authority after the judgment pronounced by the Allahabad High Court. And Morarji Desai announced that he along with lakhs of people shall gather at the PM residence and JP has given an ultimatum till 29th June. Due to the war with Pakistan and additional crisis like oil crisis and drought, the economy was in poor condition. The government strike and protest had paralyzed the government and hurt the economy of country greatly. In these circumstances, Indira Gandhi was under huge pressure. She was in need of proper solution of the situation. Therefore, सी इमीडिएटली कॉल्ड सिद्धार्थ शंकर रे द सीएम ऑफ बंगाल फॉर परफेक्ट सॉल्यूशन बिकॉज ही वॉज एन एमिनेंट लॉयर ऑल्सो ऑफ सुप्रीम कोर्ट. आफ्टर सम टाइम सिद्धार्थ शंकर रे प्रपोज टू द प्राइम मिनिस्टर टू इम्पोज एन इंटरनल इमरजेंसी. ही ड्राफ्टेड द लेटर फॉर द प्रेसिडेंट टू इश्यू द प्रोक्लेमेशन. ही शोड हाउ डेमोक्रेटिक फ्रीडम कुड बी सस्पेंडेड व्हाइल रिमेनिंग विद इन द एम्बिट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. एज द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन रिक्वायर्स मिस इंदिरा गांधी एडवाइस टू द प्रेसिडेंट फखरुद्दीन अली अहमद approved the continuation of the emergency over every 6 months until she declared to hold the general election. On February 4, 1976, Lok Sabha life extended by 1 year. The 42nd Constitution Amendment was the last impact of the national emergency. On 2nd November 1976, Lok Sabha passed 42nd Constitution Amendment Bill making India a socialist secular republic and laying down the fundamental duties of the citizen. However, Indira Gandhi shocked everybody by declaring Lok Sabha election in January 1977 and bringing an end this emergency. That was the historical Lok Sabha election held in March 1977. In the said election, Congress Party lost the war and both Indira Gandhi and her son Sanjay Gandhi were defeated. Sri Morarji Desai achieved great victory and Janata Party emerged a large party. Therefore, he formed the government and Morarji Desai became the Prime Minister in 1977 till 1979 as the fifth Prime Minister of India.